today, Mercury is entering Gemini. And Mercury is at home in Gemini. So a lot of times when we have planets, you know, coming home to their domicile, we get really excited about it. But this kind of feels like a double-edged sword a little bit to me with Mercury in Gemini. What are your thoughts on this?
It's super interesting, yeah, because like I have Gemini in my third house. So when I was thinking about this and like feeling into it, I'm like, well, typically like someone who has that Gemini energy is like, can kind of be all over the place, especially with Mercury. And the way that we communicate is kind of, you know, up, down, and around. And of course, like the multitasking piece can be there, this like juggle energy. But with the retrograde, it's like, I feel like there's going to be a lot of back and forth of old conversations, potentially old opportunities, like, and just like, yeah, I see it as like a lot of balls in the air.
That's a great way to put it. It feels very scattered when you think about Mercury in Gemini, because like the word mercurial is like what comes to mind, obviously, because yeah. Gemini is so mercurial by nature, just like your Gemini friends, Gemini energy. It's just kind of like all over the place, bouncing around. I see the pace picking up quite a bit with Mercury in Gemini, like people really wanting to speed up and do all the things and dabble in all the topics, you know. But I think this transit could kind of, oh, somebody says there's no sound. Make sure you can hear us if you're watching. Oh. Let me know. I can hear you. So just if anybody else is noticing no sound, let us know. Also, hello, everyone. Hi, Sarah. Happy to see you here. Hello, Crystal. Okay. But what I was saying is I think it comes with a warning label of like, don't let your mental capacity go into too many different directions. Because like I said, it could be very scattered, very, I don't know, just.
I know exactly what you're trying to say. Because this is my energy. I'm like, I'll just like jack of all trades is like perfect Mercury Gemini energy. And I mean, if you guys know anything about human design, like manifesting generators can also really have this energy. But it's like being mindful of what opportunities you're saying yes to. Like, you don't have to do the things just because you want to do them, right? Like, so I think that's like, yeah, I don't know. It's going to be interesting for sure.
I love that you related it to that because a lot of people have been getting into human design lately, you and I included, and we're both man-gens, of course. And I feel like that's a great way of putting it. Like, you might feel this urge to like start all the things, do all the things, and kind of convince yourself that you can do it all, you know? I would say this is a great idea or a great time to kind of dip your toe in different things and test the waters, but maybe not commit to anything, especially because we do have Mercury going retrograde on May 10th. So I think between now and then, like, follow your curiosity, see what excites you, see what's kind of piquing your interest, dabble in it. And then when Mercury is retrograde in Gemini and bouncing back into Taurus, actually, you can kind of review those interests and be like, okay, what do I actually want to move forward with? We can have a little bit more discernment and slow down a little bit during Mercury retrograde, because Mercury is going to move back into Gemini, you know, at the end of May, and we'll be right in this energy again. And hopefully with a little bit more clarity about what we really do want to devote our time and our energy to.
Yeah, actually also like, we might notice that we want to get out in our community more, like be around others. I've noticed that a little bit in terms of like, obviously we're on the online space, but I've noticed it more like people wanting to get out and like be in connection. And I think that might be something that we see more with that energy too.
Yeah, Gemini is a very social energy. It's a mutable sign, and it's known for being like the shapeshifter, right? Like Gemini energy, Gemini people can go into a lot of different environments and just immediately kind of adapt and find common ground with other people. So it's a really beautiful energy for relating, but more on like a surface level rather than depth in relating. Great time to meet new people, to put yourself out there, to kind of find that confidence and just shoot your shot, if you will. But again, like not really the time for commitment. I just see like a lot of busyness and a lot of bouncing around to different things.
Mm-hmm. Totally.
And Mercury will be in Gemini. Then it goes retrograde. It moves back into Taurus, I believe, on May 22nd. And then, you know, when it stations direct again at the beginning of June, and then it'll move back into Gemini. So it's a really extended stay, is my point. You know, when we have a retrograde in a sign like this, Mercury in its quickest transits, like 3 weeks, you know, in and out. This time we're really going to be sitting with Mercury in Gemini. And I would say also just pay attention to whatever is exciting your curiosity, like follow it. You could be really wanting to study new things during this time, gain more knowledge. And I love everybody confirming they can hear us. Thank you. Good. Thanks for the confirmation. Just Watching says, I have Gemini in the first and second house being a projector. Wait till I'm invited. So I do all the things, just not with everyone. So you're in your own little bubble studying all the things.
Also, I think it's something to note too. I don't know if anyone knows this, but like if you have Mercury retrograde in your birth chart, this is actually like a coming home energy to you. So it actually might be a good time to like harness that energy and be like, all right, like I'm gonna like use this, and what's natural to you might come a little bit easier with that energy.
I know. Somebody asked yesterday, I think, is Mercury retrograde here? Like the energy right now kind of feels similar to a retrograde already because we have the eclipse, we have a lot of movement going on. Mercury in Gemini is also, I think, going to make more people want to connect like online too, not only in person, but just it's a very technology driven transit too. So I could see also advancements in technology coming up, or like new technology coming out during this time. And maybe also us reviewing our relationship with technology during that upcoming Mercury retrograde. So lots to think about here. Thank you so much for joining us and aligning with the energy of the universe today. If you enjoyed this morning's episode of Transits Today, you can join our live astrology discussion every weekday morning right here, wherever you're watching. And head to thespiritualjournalist.com to read your daily astrology forecast and browse the Spiritual Shop, the most fun way to help keep these forecasts free and support more content like this is to buy yourself a little something on our website. But if you're feeling extra generous, you can also buy me a coffee to fuel future live streams. Just tap the link in the description or head to buymeacoffee.com and search The Spiritual Journalist. And speaking of, you can also tune in to The Spiritual Journalist, our weekly live interview where we ask our guests questions about everything from crystals and manifestation to mental health and the environment. Those conversations stream live right here, wherever you're watching now, every Tuesday. I'm so grateful you found us here, and I can't wait for our next conversation.